I am Anand, and it's my privilege to be here again. I've been visiting BMH and delivering something in the academic front the third time. So I'm very happy, and I thank Dr. Vinod for giving this opportunity to be here and talk about some interesting topic. A lot of foundational thing has been done by Dr. Shakti Kumar and Dr. Singh about this, the importance of patient safety, healthcare quality, and the impact of poor healthcare quality or impact of poor patient safety in terms of legal issues. So my talk would be something like this. If somebody remember me, in the last edition, I came with the question, can car making methods be used in healthcare? And I suggested that yes, it can be done, and I talked about few of those points. So generally before I start, I do this, but I want to thank most of the doctors and the staff for the tireless service, and I still respect you all people for all the work that you do. It includes both doctors and the staff. Thanks a lot. Why I say this? Because I'm not a profession, I'm not a doctor. I'm a mechanical engineer and I'm a professor in IIM Kozhikode. So I may not be using any of these complex terminologies such as triage or something called gastrotomy or sentinel event, all those. So please bear with me. But I am trying to learn all these new things because it is really exciting and interesting to understand about the healthcare aspects. So please bear with me if I make some mistakes. But since I am a part of a common man who has been going through this process involved in healthcare, and as a bystander and as a patient, I try to observe what's happening in a healthcare industry, in particular healthcare process. So whatever problems that were all talked about, I too have faced, I too have heard about, and I too have heard from my friends, or of course the newspaper is there, or the other mechanisms which helps us to understand the magnitude of problem. So with that note, this particular topic would be trying to understand this. Continue with the past edition of HEAP, where I started with this question, can care making methods be used to improve healthcare? In that talk, I said, what is the Toyota production system mean? What were all the 8 wastes that were there? And in particular, I showed a video of a person, a patient, who undergoes through the healthcare process and what are all the wastes that he encountered. And by the way, this is my picture last time. I was giving a talk right here and I talked about all this. And I said that the car making methods such as Toyota production system can be implemented. I had a doubt, that is why the question was there. But later in the second opportunity, again I conducted a workshop here on process improvement in lean thinking. Me and Professor Rachana Shah from University of Minnesota, we delivered a workshop, and where we talked about, since we know that it is possible, we talked about some of the tools and techniques of Toyota production system. We talked about something called 5S, we talked about Kaizen or continuous improvement, value stream mapping, etc. In line, so this is HEAP 2018, 5th edition. Just like any movies, now you have something called sequels coming up. In this sequel, in this part, I'm going to talk about one other important concept called POKAYOKE. This particular concept is again originating from Toyota production system, in particular the Japanese manufacturing methods. So we are going to talk about how these POKAYOKE can help us in reducing the problems raised by Professor Dr. Shakti Gupta and that of Dr. Singh. And how can these costs related to medical costs can be reduced, or in the case of patient safety and healthcare quality can be improved. So this is a powerful tool, but very simple tool, which we can use to improve patient quality and things. So the agenda is something like this. We will talk about this Japanese word. POKAYOKE is, by the way, a Japanese word. We will understand what is POKAYOKE, why it is needed, and that part I will not touch upon, because already it has been touched upon and the gravity of the issue is being well laid out by these two speakers. Then I will talk about what are all the different types of POKAYOKEs, what are all the different levels, how we can implement, And then we will see some of those examples that are already in place in various healthcare institutions. So let's understand this. And one important thing, if you look at this picture, the key word is this. Let's do it. So naturally, it's you, me. And when I say you, me, I consider part of yourself. So the doctors, the staff members, the technicians, everybody can try to think of some simple ways to improve patient safety and healthcare quality. Let's see how it is. So the first thing, this concept of POKAYOKE, or in a simple term called mistake proofing, was given by this gentleman called Shigeo Shingo, a Japanese management guru or an industrial engineer. And what it means, avoiding inadvertent errors. It's also called as mistake proofing. A literal translation of POKAYOKE is mistake proofing, error proofing, fool proofing, all those. So what is it? It's a mechanism to do certain activities or to design a product such a way that we will not make mistakes. When we do a process, there are certain mechanisms which will ensure that we will not make mistakes, right? Or when we use a product, there are certain mechanisms in that product which will ensure that we will not make mistakes. How is this possible? Somebody might ask, how can we have an error-free product or error-free service? POKAYOKE can do that. And please note, these mechanisms are not costly. They are inexpensive. And mostly, it relies on something which is very uncommon with us, that is common sense. All these POKAYOKE mechanisms are based on common sense. If you look at the examples that I will show, you have to use that common sense, which is very less among us. So this is about POKAYOKE. And if you look at this characteristic of POKAYOKE or mistake proofing, the purpose is this. The defects or mistakes should be identified as close as possible to the source of its occurrence. Second, upon detecting a mistake or a defect in the process should be stopped, and then some corrective action has to be taken up. The last but not the least, the process should be designed, or product or process should be designed such a way that no defect can happen. Generally, I want my class, I want my session to be interactive, so I might ask hundreds of questions in the next, or at least 30 questions in the next 30 minutes. So please feel free to answer it. But don't worry about whether it is right or wrong. I just want your perspective. Here is a picture. And I call this as a POKAYOKE device. Can somebody say how is it a mistake proofing device, or how it prevents mistakes from happening? Can somebody say this?
Nobody will take away my mobile.
One is for mobile. Okay, your focus is on mobile. But the focus is not on mobile.
Radiation,
that's too complex. As I said, POKAYOKE is all about common sense. Okay, fine, but something more. It's all about the shoes. Clue is there for you. Pardon me? Exactly. You cannot interchange the shoes and wear. Right? Left shoe has some orientation and you can only wear it on your left leg. Right shoe only on the right leg. Can anybody, you give it to anybody, this product, they can't make a mistake out of it. Right? And this is POKAYOKE for you. In the case of mobile phones, you have something called as the charging point. And today when you have something called type B charger or micro USB chargers and all, what is so unique about that? The older version. Now what we have is C-type chargers. The previous version, when you want to charge your smartphones, what happens there? Something unique. It is related to mobile also. You can put it now, the C-type charger are such a way that you can orient it in any ways. But in the previous version, there were some notches that you can insert it only in one way. And you cannot make a mistake on that. That's a POKAYOKE device. Why I am talking about all this? Because POKAYOKE devices are simple devices. It requires only common sense. And when you have common sense, chances of making mistake even inadvertently is stopped. Right? Think of a moment, what happens if at all you try to forcefully wear your shoes, interchange left shoes on right, right hand, right leg has left side shoes and the opposite. What happens? You will fall down. Typically, and that's a fall, important fall, which causes damage, which causes hurt, which hurts you. And you can't have that because of this POKAYOKE system. So this is how I'm starting my discussion. You know, now you are trying to understand what I'm talking about as POKAYOKE system, a mechanism that prevents mistakes from happening. Right? Okay. Why is it required? Which is already told by Professor Dr. Shakti Gupta. Now what I will do is I'll just play a video, because we were taking up all these, you know, literature from papers and some research paper which had around 98,000 deaths happening due to medical errors in US alone, and the cost of it was around $12 million that he was quoting. There are a few more
30-year-old data. So since then there have been some attempts to review literature, review studies that were much smaller scale. And based on the results of those studies, for example, there was one published in the Journal of Patient Safety in 2013, the estimates are in the ballpark of 200,000 to 400,000 people died annually from medical errors.
In 2013, an updated study in Journal of Patient Safety reveals that there will be an around 200,000 to 400,000 people dying of medical errors. That's the estimate, revised estimate. It is in 1996 or so, it's 98,000 people died. Now it has been estimated to be around 200,000. So such is the significance of this medical error. There's more to it. I have this YouTube video. Since the clarity is not there, let me move on and talk about the slides which I have. So this is the data that I was talking about. There can be as many as 2 errors in the ICU every day. In 2013, it was around 200 to 400,000 people. In the case of India, we don't have any data. That's the sad part, right? And generally, these are all underreported, and it's something always a troublesome area. To support that statement, this is the information that I could get from Times of India, which says, although there is no Indian data available on this topic, World Health Organization lists this as one among the top 10 killers in the world. It's not an award, but that's how they say, WHO says it's one among the top 10 killers in the world. So naturally, you could understand now the significance of POKAYOKE, why it is needed. With this simple shoe example, if you can think of no mistake can happen, we can also think of some simple measures in healthcare which would prevent this inadvertent mistakes. I am talking about prevention, right? So that is the beauty of POKAYOKE. So here are a few more examples. What is this? Video cable R, G, Y. And how will you connect your DVD player to that of your TV? Then you will use that. That video something is playing. I am not playing it, but anyway. What about this? How does it work? You just connect the red one to the red block, yellow one to the yellow block, and white one to the white block. Right? This is a POKAYOKE mechanism. If some sensible people, if it's there, they will not do the wrong connection. Foolproof. Mistake-proof. The next slide, which we all use today. And here's the case, HDMI port or USB port. You can't make mistake in connection. Anybody, even a kid, can connect there. And today, the most common usage of laptops and mobile phone is the kids, right? And they know better how to operate, and they can do the connection properly. It's a POKAYOKE device. The third type, our software are such a way that it can help us to even correct typos, spelling mistakes. POKAYOKE device for you. So we are using this POKAYOKE device in a day-to-day basis. Somehow, knowingly or unknowingly, we are using it. What happens if we can think about using this in our day-to-day healthcare operations? The moment we start thinking of such devices which can prevent mistakes, you don't need rocket science for it. You just need common sense. If you have common sense and can think of some ways your patient safety or patient safety is improved, defects, quality problems can come down. To understand that, let us explore in detail what is POKAYOKE. There are two types. The first type is called as design POKAYOKE. The equipment or products are designed in such a way that no mistake can happen while using it. Or it at least tells about the abnormal, it gives a warning sound. Let me give an example. What is this particular one? SIM tray. Right? Now, the SIM tray, SIM has to be assembled. Whether he is a 8th pass, whether he is a PhD holder, anybody can assemble the SIM in a right way. Right? It does not require any technique. Although a smartphone is a complex mechanism that you have, assembling a SIM is such an easy task. How do you think this is achieved? How can anybody, even a villager or an urban youth, can assemble this without mistake? How can it happen?
Shape.
The only thing, break the symmetry. This cut ensures that you have an orientation ensure, you know, is followed. Second, if you are inserting it, check out this hole. What is the purpose of this hole? This hole matches with the hole in the smartphone. So there is only one way it can go in. Even if you enter the tray wrongly, it will not go. Because the design is such a way that you cannot do wrong assembly. Agree? Now this is applicable for educated person as well as uneducated people. And in healthcare situation, we have different types of people. People who are super educated, you call them as doctors. And you have other people who are not that much educated, we call them as assistants or technicians or paramedics or whatever. You have all these people, mix of people. And a patient quality or safety is a function of all these people. So how are we going to make them think about this quality aspect? So POKAYOKE helps them. If they try to use their expertise, then we can do this. Next type is called as process POKAYOKE. That is, when we are doing an activity, we can prevent mistakes from happening. And for instance, what do you see here? What is this? Speedometer, which you see in a bike or car. How can this be a POKAYOKE system?
Red signifying overspeeding.
Pardon me? Yes, the color codes signify it's a overspeeding happening. Now you can ignore the speed and get into troubles, or you can slow down further, but it controls. If you add in a typical state buses, the buses which fly in the interstate buses, they have added one more component to control speed. What is that?
Speed
governors. That's a system which prevents defect from happening, which prevents overspeeding, and the chances of accidents are lesser. So that is an additional component which is also a POKAYOKE device that controls speed. So you have two types of POKAYOKEs. Either when you design your system, when you design your equipments, you can build that aspect of not making mistake, or when you are creating processes, patient flows, or your radiology process, in that can we prevent or keep some POKAYOKE systems such that mistakes don't happen. So this is what is design POKAYOKE and process POKAYOKE. In this design or process POKAYOKE, there are three levels. Let me clearly explain what it is. First type of POKAYOKE is one which identifies abnormality. It identifies problems. So that is called as defect identification level one. What would be the next one? Any guess? If a POKAYOKE system just identifies defects, that is the basic. What is the next level?
Corrective measures.
Which one?
Corrective measures.
What is the damage? No, it will not get into all those details. It will say in addition, it will give you a warning. The warning can be in the form of a light. It can be in the form of a smell. It can be in the form of an unusual sound. So these are all the warning POKAYOKEs, which not only shows the problem or mistake, but also tells you something abnormal in terms of sound, smell, etc. The third form is called as control POKAYOKE, which ensures that the wrong process is avoided. This is a particular mechanism which shows that the process is stopped the moment an abnormality is detected. So these are all the three types which are there. So to understand this, let's come back to this example. What type of POKAYOKE is this? We are grading back to the old exam.
Control.
The first one. The first one.
Color
codes. So what type of POKAYOKE is?
Design
POKAYOKE, fine. In terms of the levels.
Control.
Why? It will ensure you can still connect a white one to the red color. It's not even warning. It says some abnormality is there because it just you can perform the connection. So this is called as defect first level, level one, defect identification. When you find that the picture is not coming, immediately what they say, check the cables, how you are connected. Red would be connected with a yellow and a white would be connected with red, all that can happen, and then you will try to connect it. So it will not give warning, but it will at least indicate that there is a problem in connection. Level one, POKAYOKE. Now, second question, what is this? What type of POKAYOKE is this? It's level 3, control, you cannot make mistake. USB assembly, you cannot make mistake, right? SIM card assembly, you cannot make mistake. Or memory assembly in a computer, you cannot make mistakes. So this is called as control POKAYOKE. Naturally, you would have guessed the third type. What is it?
Warning
POKAYOKE. You can still ignore this warning that it should be software testing. But we are very fast in typing, we will still ignore and say with software, without e-testing, we will click Google, it will give answer. But it will say, I have searched for software testing instead of the mistake which you have. Anyway, this is how we can classify level 1, level 2 and level 3 POKAYOKE. Now we need to design in your process such different types of POKAYOKE system. Let's look at it. If you want to understand this, let's look at it. Let's skip this video. I have got a manufacturing video to talk about how it works. I'm just skipping it because it's not working and it may take time. If you look at manufacturing and that of healthcare, you can see many similarities. Let me highlight what are all those. First, many trainee doctors, trainee nurses or trainee technicians learn the trick of the trade only on the job, right? You have all these people coming in for you and they'll be doing all this. And they take part in all these diagnosis procedures. Naturally, when they are supposed to do some work, chances of mistakes are higher during their on-the-job training. And you can't say that at the end, it's my trainee did, hence there's a patient problem. You can't say, it's a hospital. But you have to also do this because that's how you train people. So you are in a dilemma, a situation, a catch-22 situation where you have to employ new people. At the same time, you cannot worry, say that it's because my trainee did the problem happen, you cannot escape also. So this is a problem which is also existing in manufacturing because you have to train new people. Next, we also do a lot of complex tasks as in a manufacturing. See, assembly of computer is a complex task. Making a mobile phone is a complex task. Think of all the activities that you do in terms of a surgery, really complex task, right? Think of CT scan or something, it's also a complex task which involves certain sequence to be followed. And the biggest problem in a healthcare situation is, all these sequence might be violated if your patients are not cooperating, or the person called customer, when they are involved in the process, and if they are not cooperating, you will have problems. In a manufacturing, that's the advantage. Only the machine can create problem. Here, the person who is involved, who is a patient, he may also, or his bystander would also create problems in your following the process. So this is another biggest challenge that we have. Third, we also use in manufacturing very complex, sophisticated equipments. The same applies here. Lot of complex equipments that you also use. Now, when you have all this similarity, apart from this, we use something called raw materials, plastics, metals. Here you use consumables, equivalent amount to treat patients. So if you look at all this similarity, manufacturing and healthcare processes have lot in common, apart from the problem of defects. Manufacturing also defect exists, in healthcare also defects exist. So one big answer is, apart from this work pressure and stress, phenomenal in today's industry in manufacturing, the same applies in healthcare too. So having said this, when you have so many characteristics that are similar to for a manufacturing, why can't you apply the POKAYOKE system, which is very prevalent in manufacturing, in healthcare? So that is another reason why I am saying that car making methods can still be applied in healthcare, right? So with that note, let's understand what are all the potential mistakes. It's already done, but just to, you know, tell the importance, something as crazy as this can also happen, right? You can also have these types. And we talked about surgery done in wrong area, wrong dosage, wrong medications, hospital acquired infections, all those, right? Is all this are the reason for your poor patient safety, poor healthcare quality? Can we avoid these mistakes? We have a team of people who perform surgery. Can we avoid these educated people who are there performing the surgery? Can they avoid these mistakes? If so, can you think of POKAYOKE systems? Yes. So how? Now that's what we are trying to understand. I have few examples of POKAYOKE system, but since video is not working, let's try to minimize that. If you look at simplest of simplest POKAYOKE, which you might be following, I'm not saying you are not following, you might be following, something called as checklist and counts, right? Which is to overcome this problem of surgical leftovers, which can happen. What is the problem with that? It's a good tool.
Implementation.
Implementation. What happens in the implementation part?
Importance level is low.
No, what happens is, before even all the surgery or the process happens, ticking happens. You will do the ticks and then only perform the other activities. That's the problem. The discipline is the problem. So what you have to do, the moment you do each of these activities, at the corresponding time you need to make the check marks or the counts you have to ensure. But unfortunately, we don't follow the discipline, hence this effectiveness is gone. One other suggestion that was talked about is the case of Sri Devi's mother. Brain tumor in one side and the operation happened on the other side, or the surgery happened on the other side. How this can be avoided? Put a simple cross mark wherever it is on the patient. That solves the purpose. In Arvind Eye Care, they do this. They also ask the patients, if they are, you know, in the pre-operative procedure, they ask, which side of your eye you need to perform the surgery. And the patient says this, which is a double confirmation for the other. So apart from marking, apart from the papers that you have, the so-called medical records, ask the customers, ask the patients.
It's already there.
But sometimes these are all not done. The biggest problem is lack of discipline. Right? Simple POKAYOKE system. The third type. Compulsory use of sanitizers to prevent hospital-acquired infections. How many of us do that? Wonderful standard operating procedures you have got. Wonderful auditors come and check it. It's all there. Dispensing units are there. But still then, why it is happening? So, lack of discipline. So, but this is, if the video plays, if he helps me out, then there's a wonderful video about how this POKAYOKE system can ensure sanitization, standard operating procedures, etc. So let me talk about some basic ideas of healthcare. Something very complex for me, but you people can understand, right? It is something called as esophageal intubation. Is my pronunciation right?
Yes.
Right. If that is right, you try to, you know, send this tube to the patient's stomach, sorry, to the patient's lungs, but it went into the stomach. But what should be the case? How to detect whether it has gone to the right location or not? Have this simple air pump or, you know, the bubble, press that squeeze bulb, insert it and then send it. When it goes to the lungs, because of respiration, it should move out. The squeezed bulb should come out properly. It should become bulged. So if that's how the example says. That's why I said don't shake by your head. I might be wrong also. But this is one simple methodology that people employ, just to say whether the position is right or wrong, right? So this is one simple situation. The next simple situation for the sanitizer is, if a video can be played, that would be really good, right? For sanitization system, they have a wonderful video, which ensures, and you cannot make a mistake in that, very simple system that they have got in one of the UK hospital, you can check it. By the way, when we talk of all these disciplines and common sense and this POKAYOKE system, whom do you think is responsible for it? Who is responsible to put those systems in place? Who is responsible to devise these simple methods?
Administration.
Top management.
No, ma'am. Top management need not worry about it. It's the process associates, the one frontline employees who do all these jobs day in, day out. They know it. And it is that we have to tap their knowledge. Only thing is we don't listen to them. So unless the moment we start thinking about those people, you will have interesting videos coming up. With such simple mechanisms in place, the concept of patient safety is ensured. The chances of mistakes are reduced. And if you can think of, if you make use of the team effort of your, you know, the frontline associates governed by senior administrators, you can come up with many such POKAYOKE system, mistake-proofing system, such that the chances of errors are minimized. And probably that leads to lesser medico-legal costs, that leads to improved patient satisfaction, that might lead to overall good atmosphere in the hospital. And naturally, once your brand image, once you are famous for all this, your brand image can also increase. So this is a beautiful system called POKAYOKE, which is followed in manufacturing. And do we have time? 10 minutes more. Then if you don't mind, can I play that manufacturing video? Is it okay?
Various types of sequencers and indicators are assembled on the fifth floor, and different work procedures and parts are used. For this reason, the cell production method was employed more than 10 years ago. The cell production method is suited to manufacturing various products in small...
assembling certain parts using different types of screws. Something like you can relate it to a healthcare, which can happen in any of the activities. Some of these steps have to be followed in sequence. So let's look at how this particular lady is going to do this multiple task in certain sequence without any mistake consistently. And how these machines that are there is going to also help them in achieving this, you know, POKAYOKE system, or this, you know, achieving zero defects.
In the screw tightening job instruction system, the indicator screen in front of the worker displays the type and number of screws and the type of electric screwdriver to be used. The LED lamp lights up to indicate the next screwdriver to be used. The worker can accurately take out screws and select the next screwdriver without checking the job instruction. The indicator displays the screw tightening position and tightening order. The color of the tightened screws changes on the...
If you look at, there's one light at the end which also glows green when she performs each of these tasks correctly. That shows that, yes, she has done this, you know, the applying the screw, she has done it correctly.
Display, so that the...
This is the point which I was talking about. This light glows green every time she does the task correctly.
Next screw tightening position can be checked at a glance. In addition to instructing the work procedures, the system can automatically determine the quality of screw tightening by using the sensor installed in the back of the screwdriver. If a screw is not properly tightened, the red patrol light and buzzer informs the worker of a problem, and the screwdriver is turned off to prevent the worker from performing the next job.
Alright, so this is how multiple items, you know, you also use multiple instruments, multiple consumables, surgery is performed, this happens. How to ensure that the correct search methods or correct instruments is used, correct consumables are used? Probably someday we have to think of this. Here what we have is an indicator system. Now if you look at, once a mistake is made, the system gives an alarm, and then the operator read through the work, which should not happen quite often, but she tries to redo the work so that the mistake is not happening. Now, two questions for you. What type of POKAYOKE is this? We talked about different types of POKAYOKE. It's a control POKAYOKE or warning POKAYOKE. It's a combination of both. One important point about control POKAYOKE, it should stop the process, right? Now, in this case, the moment something goes wrong, it stops the screwing process. It cannot further screw it because some mistakes have happened. So she has to unscrew it, she has to shift the lever, unscrew it, and then redo this. So it's a combination of both control and warning POKAYOKE. It gives out a warning saying that something is wrong, and it also does not allow the screwdriver to work next, so that wrong assembly can happen, might happen. So since this is a combination of control and warning POKAYOKE. In terms of types, we talk about design POKAYOKE, process POKAYOKE. What type of POKAYOKE is this? It's a process POKAYOKE. Because in the activity, when something is made, we are trying to make sure that no error happens in making that product. In a healthcare situation, when a surgery happens, we do a process, and in that process, we don't want any errors to creep in. So then that becomes a process POKAYOKE. So this is an example of process POKAYOKE, where the product is made and we are not allowing any defect to happen. So this is a simple example of manufacturing. So let's do a quick review. I want the slides back. Understand it. That's I am coming to the end of the lecture. So it's something like I talked about as mistake proofing device. They need to be simple, they need to be cost effective, use of common sense, and most importantly, when a mistake happens, it should give the immediate feedback. It should be identified at the source. At the end, it should not be identified. Then it becomes very complex where mistake happens. At the source, we need to identify, and POKAYOKE does that. And let's look at this review. There are many applications. The first one, what type of POKAYOKE is this? Where do you use this?
Level one.
So what type of POKAYOKE?
Design.
The first level. I mean, here only the cables are there. The machine is not there yet. So what type of POKAYOKE?
Identification.
It just identifies. The color codes identifies the corresponding part in your body to that of the terminal. So identification. The moment the machine comes in, and if there is a wrong connection, the machine will not even function, or it gives out a warning. So the moment it is combined with the machine, then it becomes a warning POKAYOKE. Currently, it's a level 1 POKAYOKE. It just combines the colors. This is in your treadmill test. Control,
yeah.
How does this work? It immediately stops. It does not allow the process to happen. So this is like an emergency stop. And any abnormality happens, if due to some reasons, the moment the clip comes off, then we have a stop process, a control POKAYOKE. Whatever POKAYOKE is.
Warning
POKAYOKE. So it just gives out a warning. Any abnormality happens, low heart rate or high heart rate, it just gives out an error, gives out a warning. So immediate corrective action taken. Right? But it does not do anything else to revive a life or stop the process. By the way, and that is not required also. We don't want the thing to stop your heartbeat or something. So it just gives out a warning. Now all these are not POKAYOKE devices which are being followed. So if so, can you think of new ways in your processes, in your work area, and try to ensure that no mistakes can happen in those areas? Don't think complex. Think something simple. Use color codes. Use some checklist. Use something like, a fail-safe mechanism. Think of ideas what you can contribute to the hospital in terms of patient quality. It does not require the support of top management. Use your common sense. Common sense can give more ideas, and hence overall, if more departments gives out these common sense ideas, overall it benefits the organization. So I reiterate that point. Manufacturing methods, car making methods can still be applied in healthcare. And if you beautifully adapt it to the situation, you will have a lot of benefits. So I thank you all for the opportunity. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask me. I can help you out with whatever limited knowledge I have.
Thank you, sir, for the knowledge session.
Sir, at present, this POKAYOKE system is being used in the government sector. That in the national quality assurance standards, there is a measurable elements of POKAYOKE in the name of this
group.
We started to do it.
Very good. Okay. So it is already there.
Already there, just been started.
But whether it reminds us a documentation effort or an actual thing?
Actually doing it in a simple way.
Okay.
Some more quality tools are being used, PDCA.
PDCA, 7QC tools, and all you might use. But POKAYOKE is a very simple device. So if it is being enforced from an authority level or as a certification level, I hope your forthcoming quality of, this problem should subside over a period of time.
It is happening in different levels, right? I started just now.
But who is creating those ideas, sir?
No,
that is a requirement. When it is operationalized, so that is a problem. Now you are saying that these ideas should come only from the quality department. No, they can do that. But we need to take the help of your process associates who are doing it day in, day out, the same job. They know better. They have ideas. Tap them. With the support of quality, you do, you will get many things. Absolutely. Teamwork and collaborative effort with frontline people is required. Field people is required rather than forcing something from the top. So when you try to do this, you will see that, and you can easily meet your one of the criteria also. So that way it is beneficial. Thank you. Thanks a lot for the input for me that it is part of your accreditation or certification criteria. Thanks a lot.